Welcome to another adventure with Getting Lost. We are here at Yishun Avenue 1. Yes, what are we going to do here today? Your guess is as good as mine. Well, to find out, you'll just have to join me after the intro. Thank you for joining me again, and as you can see, we are along Yishun Avenue 1, and we're actually along Lower Seletar Reservoir, and we're going to walk across the Yishun Dam. And this reservoir, the water in the reservoir here, was actually created from this dam here. This dam was actually built across the mouth of the Seletar River in 1983, and in the past it was known as Sungai Seletar Reservoir. And later the area, not here, here's the sea, the one on the other side there, part of the reservoir, was renamed Lower Seletar Reservoir in 1992. And this is actually a very important river. And across there, first of all, you see it's Johor. So now we're actually going to walk across the dam. But before that, I said that this river is a very historic river, or Sungai Seletar was actually a very historic river, because in the annals reported that in the early 15th century, the ruler of Singapore, Iskandar Shah, escaped to Mua via Seletar River from the invading Javanese. So the ruler of Singapore that time must have gone past here to head towards Mua. And also Seletar River, or used to be the Seletar River, played a crucial role in the development of this area. The first migrants here arrived via the river. Plantations was also first established at the foot of the river and along it, and businessmen used to ship their produce to town by boat down the Seletar River. But the Seletar River, like I told you earlier, has been dammed, and the water from the river started to fill up the reservoir. And what we get now is Lower Seletar Reservoir, which is across the road there. So the river used to come all the way up to here. What we can see now is there's actually a bridge over there, and then there's also some jetties, which is something you don't see in Singapore, or you don't expect to see anymore in Singapore nowadays. And let's just have another view of Lower Seletar Reservoir from across the street. And if you remember, I think last year, we actually went to Lower Seletar Reservoir Park, which is right at the other end of the reservoir. And you also may not know that in the night, sometimes there are some spooky or supernatural things happening here, because there is a history in this area here of mass beheading during the Japanese occupation. So it is not uncommon for some people to see headless ghosts in the area, or hear their cries and screams. Yes, cries and screams. So don't be surprised if you have some supernatural experiences here. And look at that, there are actually jetties here and a mangrove swamp. So in that area, what you can see, you can actually see jetties and also a mangrove swamp. And if you actually head further down in that direction, you'll notice there are actually some makeshift offices here or buildings. Okay, and that's actually the area. Over there is actually, if you look at this place here, it's actually a jetty called Jernal Jetty. And this area here is one of the last surviving fishing villages in Singapore. Last few. So what happens is, the fishermen, Singaporean fishermen, actually do not actually live in this area here. They actually use this place for work. And if you keep heading down that direction, you know, heading towards the bridge, I noticed that the bridge is actually close to pedestrian traffic. So the only way to cross the bridge is to have a vehicle, which we do not have at this moment. In the future, we may go another adventure to go across over there, but at the moment, we have to turn back and head away from the fishing village. Like I said, the fishing village here, or the Jernal Jetty, is one of the last few locations in Singapore where Singaporean fishermen actually go out and fish. So there's a jetty there, and they also have to keep their boats there. They actually do fishing. And if you actually head across over here, there's actually a small little park that we can actually go to. On my left now, they're actually doing some renovation to the park. So half the park is actually under renovation, but we can go to the other part here. But what we came here for is to look at the Lower Seletar Reservoir. And in the distance is Yishun Dam and the pump station. And then over there is a golf course. And you can see from the color of the water here at the reservoir that the reservoir is very deep. Nice dark blue color means that it's a very deep reservoir. And you just keep heading along this small little park, which is just right next to the reservoir. In that direction, you will come to another PUB pump station. And if you look at the water, look down at the water, the water is really clear and clean. And in the distance there, if you see zoom in, you can actually see that in that direction is where we visited last year, the Lower Seletar Reservoir Park. And this is the golfing course that is right next to the park. And in the distance there, you can actually see the satellite dishes. Yes, if we remember, we were actually heading to the Sungai Seletar Park Connector, and we actually saw some satellite dishes from the distance. Yeah, so this is actually from there. So that direction there is where our park is that we went to last time. And as we keep heading down this park, what I must say is, if you actually head towards your left across and walk across the Seletar West Link Road, you actually come to this place called the Seletar Aerospace Park. So when you're actually walking along the park, you can also hear like planes in the background. And the aerospace park is where a lot of the aerospace companies actually have their offices. And here we see another bird in behind the tree. Like I said, these birds are actually wintering birds that came down to Singapore, on their way, making a stop here before they continue their journey to another country. So places like this, this reservoir, you know, like MacRitchie, you know, all these kind of places are a very good place for them to come and rest before they continue their journey. And the more pristine, the more clean, the more beautiful we can keep this place, the more these birds will come to Singapore. And if we keep heading down that direction, we will actually reach the pump station. Another pump station where they can actually use the water from the reservoir to clean it, to make it into drinking water. So, and if we keep heading down to the car park, and then we turn right here and head down that direction to the end, you also have another secret of the park that not many people know about. And if you walk up these small little steps here, at the top there, you notice there's actually a grave. This mysterious grave is the grave of Mrs. Jane Byers. And how this grave appeared here is, first of all, what happened was rubble, which came from the exhumed Kampong Java Cemetery off Bukit Timah Road, were actually used in the construction of the Seletar Country Club's clubhouse and golf course. So crushed gravestones and stone materials were used from the construction work, and one such gravestone belonged to her. It was found by contractors in the 1970s, and they actually installed this here, as in this present location you see here now, as a mark of respect to the deceased. So according to history, Jane Byers was actually the wife of Mr. John Craig Byers, a shipbuilder who arrived in Singapore in the mid-1850s from Sheerness, Scotland. She died in 1867 and was believed to be buried in the Kampong Java Cemetery. So, I'm glad that I can actually share with you this little secret place that not many people know of in Singapore, here at Lower Seletar Reservoir. I hope you enjoyed this little tidbit. Anyway, thank you very much for joining me here today for my adventure here at Yishun Dam. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned something new and enjoyed the natural beauty of the dam or the reservoir. Lower Seletar Reservoir is still very beautiful. And before you go, please do me a favor. Please help me by liking my video, sharing my video, and subscribing to my channel. You don't have to, but I would appreciate it if you do. And lastly, but the most important thing, the thing that you must do is to join me for my next adventure. See you then. Bye-bye.